and I'm glad to be here today. It's the third edition, and just expect nothing but magic.
Feels amazing, and he's doing this for a really good cause and bringing a lot of African culture to America.
He's very passionate about his love for African music, so that we stand our feet here in the United States of America, that we cross boundaries and African music can be appreciated.
Take a trip back to April 8th, 1973, to a small town in Imo State on the east side of Nigeria. The man that would be known to the world as Anderson, Big A, Obiagwu, was born. Raised in the industrious town of Aba in Abia State, Anderson learned through his surroundings the real fundamentals of life. He grew up with the belief that through hard work, dedication, and most important, discipline, that any and everything is possible. His parents, Sir Eleazar and Lady Agnes Obiagwu, instilled in him the true value of a solid education.
Everybody that grew up in Aba back in the days was industrious. We were all industrious because when school wasn't in session, we hustled. We made clothes, sold clothes. You know, some of us worked at helped our parents, worked with our parents, helped their businesses. And whenever school wasn't in session, we just go to their offices, the businesses, and help them out.
He attended the Okigwe Road Primary School in Aba, then went off to secondary school, where destiny would reveal itself and he would meet the love of his life.
I met Anderson in secondary school. I went to Federal Government Girls College, Owerri. It's an all-girls boarding school. And he went to Holy Ghost College in the same city. And we had this event that held at the church, at the big cathedral church in Owerri.
High school was beautiful. That was where I first met my wife. When I first met my wife, that was 1988 when I first met her. It was in Owerri. She was going to school in a different school, Federal Government Girls College Owerri, and I was going to Holy Ghost College Owerri. So we met at a college function.
I was in the tent as a queen, and what happens is you have a queen in the tent, and then people pay money and come in, and there's a game. It's called the Devil's Mailbag. So you get to pick your question, and whatever you pick is what you do when you get in the tent. And so Anderson came in the tent, and he saw me, and he liked what he saw. And he came several times. I noticed him, but I didn't know who he was.
We dated. It was amazing. Then I moved to Dallas. When I moved to Dallas, 1996. Went to school, graduated, and it was just a different life, a different world. Just like a totally different culture. I had that culture shock, and I had to readjust and worked so many different jobs till I graduated from college, and then started working in the hospital as a therapist, and then the music came in.
Big A has always been a fan of the entertainment arts, from the lifestyles of the performers down to the intricacies of the industry itself. As with any burgeoning venture, there are its ups and downs.
Oh Lord, that was a nightmare, MC Galaxy. He had come out here for the NEA Awards, and then he reached out to me and wanted us to do a couple of CDs, do a couple of shows while he was here, so booked him in DC. So it was a whole lot of mix-up. Long story short, we got to DC. MC Galaxy was shooting a video the same night of the show. Promoter got pissed, really, really pissed. And he was really upset. You shooting a video on my clock. How is that gonna happen? It's just one of those things. The artist didn't know any better. Because he just got in the industry. He had never done any tour here in America. So the promoter got really pissed. And some scuffle happened, but nobody got hurt.
There are so many experiences that come up when you go on tour. There are times when you run into funny promoters who try different things. In some other instances too, you meet some really effective promoters. They know exactly what they're doing. They pick you at the airport right on time, take you to your hotel, get you food, make sure they're there to pick you on time when it's time to perform. They pay the balance, no hassles, nothing, no hanky-panky, no trying to be smart.
But Big A and his team persevered and maintained a heavy presence in the world of Afrobeats, being one of the early pioneers to help properly license and sanction some of the shows for the artists to perform at through various ventures throughout the United States.
Big A Entertainment is the first tour outfit in the United States to be securing proper work permits for artists to come and perform in America.
Afrobeats wasn't really big out here in America. Like, it was just people just played it in their cars, but you didn't hear that in clubs or malls like we do today. So after that trip to Canada, when I got back to Dallas, you know, I spoke to a couple of friends of mine. It was three of them. You know, I spoke to Stanley, spoke to Chike, and yeah, Tankraya, and you know, we decided to register a company.
My name is Yazo Mamu Gochukwu Tetemana Puntalagan Ibekwe, Tankraya DFW. I want to say big congratulations to Big A Entertainment, 10-year anniversary. I've known him for about 15 years. Oh, back in the days, 2005, 2006, 2007. Big A and his wife, they threw the best parties in Dallas-Fort Worth. You know, everybody showed up at one of these parties. All the husbands met their wives at those parties. The wives met their husbands there. There was a baby boom around that time. A lot of babies were born within those 3 years. But when it came to 2007, 2008 and 2009, we started talking about bringing African artists to Dallas. We were tired of going to Houston for shows, so we decided to bring them here. There were about four of us at that time. We formed a group called New Era, and we did a very big show, Thanksgiving of 2009. We brought Timaya. Well, Timaya was supposed to come, but he didn't show up. We brought Omotola, Kelly Handsome, and a few other acts. It was the biggest show that Dallas has ever seen as far as African entertainment.
Big A and his team created the company called African Music Magazine. Through this venture, the AFRIMA Award Show was born.
The most toughest nigga in the industry, I tell you. Troy, toughest boss in the industry.
After we completed the P Square concert, I remember sitting in his office and he said, I'm thinking about starting an award show. And that's pretty much how AFRIMA was born.
The original movers in a business movement at the beginning. So it was Idem, Jimbo, and Rabaki, and Emmanuel Iben. I guess those were the first original movers in the business when we started.
If you ever met Big A, at the first instant, you already know it's not gonna be a pleasant meeting at all. Cause he never smiles. He never smiles. He's always short, like straight. His face is always straight. He never smiles. It takes a lot for him to smile.
With the success of AFRIMA, many African artists have gained the worldwide recognition that their talents have shown to help further their emerging genre of Afrobeats.
I met Big A, I think, 2017. I wanted to come to the United States on a U.S. tour, and I knew he was a big promoter. I knew he had done a lot of tours with a lot of big artists. So my management reached out, like, you know, let's do this, let's kill this tour. First bad guy coming to the USA, and he turned out to be an amazing guy. You know, we had such great working chemistry, and you know, he's just a very genuine person, and you know, that's what I like the most about him.
Everything that the company has done has been in direct alignment with that mission. And so when AFRIMA was created, it was just the natural next step to help bring Afrobeat music to a global platform.
He has managed to do us proud as far as African music. He has managed to do us proud as far as crossing boundaries, bringing African artists here to the DFW, to diaspora as a whole, and introducing them to things that they haven't seen before.
He was still very surprised at the turnout and close to all the AFRIMA awards that we've had. You know, it's been crazy. You know, each one every year has been a plus and a negative, and all we had to do was put that energy together to build up another successful year.
There are, however, many other sides to Anderson than just entertainment. He's a man that firmly believes in putting his family first. Without the stability and support of his family, he wouldn't be able to carry on with the journey of excellence that he's seeking. Together with his wife, Ifama, they're raising three beautiful children. He heavily makes sure that he's involved with the lives of his children and is an active father.
We're like younger, you know, we don't understand, obviously, but now that we're older and we understand more things, we know that what he does is like takes a lot of sacrifice and time and effort, and how he cares a lot about Africa and what he's trying to do to bring the culture of Africa to America, and how hard he's been working. And it's just a blessing to have a father that cares that much about other people and how he tries to influence America. Especially when we went to Afrima for the first time a couple years back, we're able to see what he's done and how it's actually influenced everyone around him, what it's actually done, and all the work and what has actually come of all the work he's put. So we went there and we were really shocked and amazed. And that was our first time really witnessing the true magnitude of what he's done and what it's brought about.
Having the support of his wife for 20 years makes the journey that much smoother.
It's very tough. Like in the beginning, it's very tough for a marriage when your husband is gone for long periods of time traveling, and also the environment, you know, where the events are held. What do you do as a wife? All you can do is support him. I lift him up in prayer. You know, we've had our ups and downs, but we put God first.
Without my family, I don't think I would have been in this business till now, especially the late nights, the travels, the touring, the just name it. You know, the promoting this music business is very, very time consuming. You know, my wife has been very understanding. She's like Team Big A. Like, it's just whatever we need to do to get the job done. And you know, when these artists are on tour, her hospitality, she opens up her doors. She cooks for them. Like, it's when we talk with artists, it's more like a family. It's just like a family unit.
The show must go on, as they say. The emerging genre of Afrobeats continues to infiltrate pop culture worldwide. Acts such as Basket Mouth, Fouls, Flavor, and many other talented artists continue to elevate Afrobeats in conjunction with African Music Magazine.
If somebody were to ask me, has Afrima made an impact on Afrobeat music and the culture as a whole, I would totally say yes. People than just a music award show, it's been an opportunity to connect Africans as a whole. It's not segmented, it's not just Nigerians, it's not just Ghanaians, it's not just Kenyans, it's for Africans as a whole. And not only Africans, it's for everyone.
Everything you guys have talked about, planned in the meetings, come to flourish right in front of your eyes, because you know you've done something great for the culture. And that's all Biggie usually is all about. It's all about is pushing the culture.
The lifestyle of an artist and promoter is a very stressful one. However, the passion, dedication, and general love of the culture makes the journey that much worthwhile.
The end goal is always the most important, making sure the show and the event comes out right. There are times when problems can come from artists, it can come from the fans, it can come from sound equipment. It could be anything, really. You just have to be prepared. And the kind of training that Anderson gave us is for us to be able to come up with a solution anytime something comes up.
Lots of investing, but at the end of the day, nothing good comes easy. It takes a lot of time, devotion and dedication. And because of the passion that he has for what he's so passionate about African, you know, music and culture. Crossing boundaries with music is something he's very serious about. And he's put everything he has into this entertainment business.
Meaning when you get those setbacks and you get those pushbacks and people are not returning phone calls or people are not honoring their agreement, you still in the back of your head have to know, I understand why I'm doing this. I understand how important it is that I give these artists a platform to be heard. I understand how important it is to showcase this music. I understand how important it is to showcase this culture.
Providing a path and opportunity for the new generation of music lovers and those who create it is a shared passion that regardless of how many hours of negotiations and sleepless nights occur, the ends justify the means.
It's been a wonderful ride. He's an awesome human being. He inspires me a lot with his will and his passion and his ability to like push himself to the limits to get the maximum and to deliver his best always.
Through helping to push this music form to a global marketplace, it showcases all the beautiful things about Africa, the food, the dress, the people. Music is something that unifies Africans as a whole. We love music. And Afrima has been a platform to showcase our artists, to celebrate them.
Which leads to a singular vision, which is to be the best promotion company in the African music industry.
Hard work and the passion that he puts into whatever he believes in, it's something worthy of emulating. And it's a key trait that describes him. Once he sets up, once he sets his sight on a goal, he works assiduously to achieve that goal.
So I envision the music to continue to gain commercial appeal, and people really embrace the sound, and people will continue to support the event, and it'll continue to grow. Ultimately, my hope for Afrima is that it will grow to be as big as South by Southwest and some of the biggest festivals and events in this world, and it's possible. So until then, we'll just keep crossing boundaries with music.
My advice to young promoters that are trying to get into the game is just, first of all, you have to have passion for it. You have to do it for the right reasons. If you don't have passion for it, you're gonna burn out. Trust me, it's not an easy job. Trust me. So I've gotten this close a million times to quitting. But I just, what kept me in there, what kept me moving was just the passion. You know, it's gonna pay off, but you just have to pay your dues, you have to put in the work. It's not gonna come easy. But now my brother, the girl they want to follow. Get on now, only like he say, I really love you. Cause I follow my door, and me for solid.